अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज आइकोसानॉइड्स। आइकोसानॉइड्स आर अ कम्प्लेक्स टाइप ऑफ लिपिड्स दैट इंक्लूड द ल्यूकोट्राइन, थ्रोम्बोक्सेन्स एंड प्रोस्टाग्लैंडिन्स एज वेल। सो लेट्स सी व्हाट इज एक्चुअली आइकोसानॉइड्स। Eicosanoids come from the eicosa, and in Greek it is used for the word 20. So it is the collective term for oxygenated derivatives of three different 20 carbon fatty acids. So we can say that eicosanoids are mainly three different oxygenated derivatives of 20 carbon fatty acids, and three different 20 carbon fatty acids are eicosapentaenoic acid EPA and omega 3 fatty acid with the 5 double bonds. The second one is arachidonic acids, abbreviated as AA, and omega 6 fatty acid with the 4 double bonds. And the third one is dihomo gamma linolenic acid, abbreviated as DGLA. It is an omega 6 fatty acid with 3 double bonds. So we can roughly understand the eicosanoids as the signaling molecule. They are made by the oxidation of 20 carbon fatty acids, and they exert the complex control over many body system, in which mainly include the inflammation. They also act as a messenger in the central nervous system. Actually, the networks of control that depends upon the eicosanoids are among the most complex in the human body. Eicosanoids are derived from either omega 3 or omega 6 fatty acids. In general, omega 6 eicosanoids are pro-inflammatory. Omega 3s are much less pro-inflammatory. The amount and the balance of these fats in the person's diet will affect the body's eicosanoids control and functions, which will in turn affects on the cardiovascular disease, triglycerides, blood pressures and arthritis. Anti-inflammatory drugs such as aspirin and other NSAIDs act by down-regulating the eicosanoid synthesis. Classes of eicosanoids. As we know that the three different kind of 20 carbon atom complex fats are called eicosanoids, there are many subclasses, but mainly eicosanoids can be divided into two main classes. The first class is called classic eicosanoids, and the second class is called novel eicosanoids. Leukotrienes and prostanoids are termed as the classic eicosanoids. Current usage limits the term of leukotriene and three type of prostanoids under the above class, that are the prostaglandins, prostacyclines, thromboxanes. जी द सेकेंड क्लास इज कॉल्ड द नॉवल आइकोसानाइड्स एंड इट इज़ ऑल्सो द नॉन क्लासिक आइकोसानाइड्स सेवरल क्लासेज आर टेक्निकली टर्म्ड इन द नॉवल आइकोसानाइड्स एंड दे इंक्लूड हिपोसिलीन्स रिजॉल्विन्स आइसोफ्यूरॉन्स आइसोप्रोस्टेटेन्स लिपोक्सिन्स एपीलिपोक्सिन्स एपॉक्सी आइकोसा स्टीरिनोइक एसिड एंड एंडोकैनाबिनॉइड्स दे आर क्लासिफाइड इन टू द नॉवल क्लास ऑफ आइकोसानॉइड्स. How to find a particular icosanide that this is it is an icosanide? Actually, a particular icosanide is a systematic name, and that name is denoted by four character abbreviations that are composed of two letters abbreviation. For example, for prostaglandins, PG is used. One ABC sequence letter mean the category of that prostaglandin is A, C, D or anyone depending on its structural difference. A subscript indicating the number of double bonds. For example, the EPA derived prostanoids have three double bonds PGG3, PGH3, PGI3, TXA3, while its leukotrienes have five and it will be LTB5. The AA archidonic acid derived prostanoids have two double bonds, for example PGG2, PGH2, PGI2, TXA2, while its leukotriene have four double bond as LTB4. If we see the structure, the prostaglandin is E1, the five member ring is the characteristic of this class. If we see the structure of thromboxane and leukotriene, thromboxane A2, oxygen have moved into the ring and it make its the thromboxane A2. Leukotriene B4, note that the three conjugated bond present in the leukotriene B4. Prostacycline I2, the second ring, distinguish it from the prostaglandins, and the leukotriene E4 is an example of cysteine leukotriene. To understand the complexity of the icosanides and their complex role in the messaging network of the body, we should see some metabolic action of the prostanoids and the leukotrienes. PGD2 promote the sleep and PGE2 promotes smooth muscle contraction, inducing the pain, heat, fever and bronchoconstriction. PGII-alpha promotes the uterine contraction and PGI2 inhibition of the platelet segregation and the vasodilation. Likewise, TXA2, thromboxanes A2, stimulation of platelets aggregation and vasoconstriction. 15D PGJ2, adipocytes differentiation, and LTB leukocytes chemotaxis. So these are the complex and the important metabolic function which the leukotriene and the prostanoids perform in the metabolic system. Function of eicosanoids. Eicosanoids are the main complex control over the body system, and eicosanoids exert a complex control over the body system mainly in the inflammatory and in the immunity. As a messenger in the central nervous system, they are found in most living things. In the human, eicosanoids are the local hormones that are released by most cells, act on the small cells or nearby cells. That is, they are the autocrine and the paracrine mediator, and then are rapidly inactivated. Eicosanoids have the short lifetime, ranging from seconds to minutes. Dietary antioxidant inhibits the generation of some inflammatory eicosanoids. For example, resveratrol against the thromboxane and some leukotriene. Most eicosanoid receptors are member of G protein coupled receptor superfamily, and they are specific. At the last, we should see the biosynthesis of eicosanoids, how the eicosanoids are synthesized in the body. Eicosanoid, because the eicosanoids are not stored within the cells, but they are synthesized as required, and they are derived from the fatty acids that make up the cell membranes and the nuclear membranes. Many enzymes involved in the eicosanoid synthesis, for example, cyclooxygenase, lipoxygenase, 5-lipoxygenase. Eicosanoid biosynthesis begins when a cell is activated by mechanical trauma, cytokines, growth factor, or other stimuli. The stimulus may even be an eicosanoid from a neighboring cell. The pathways are complex. This triggers the release of a phospholipase at the cell membrane. The phospholipase travels to the nuclear membrane. There, the phospholipase catalyzes the ester hydrolysis of phospholipids or diacylglycerol. This make free a 20 carbon fatty acids, and this hydrolysis appears to be rate determining steps for eicosanoids biosynthesis. Phospholipase A2. The fatty acid may be released by any of the several phospholipases. Of these, type 4 cytosolic phospholipase A2 is the key actor. As the cells lacking CPLA2 are in general devoid of the eicosanoids synthesis. The phospholipase CPLA2 is the specific for the phospholipids that contain the AAEPA or the GPLA at the SN2 position. Interestingly, CPLA2 may also release the lysophospholipids that becomes the platelets activating factor as well. And you can see and understand from the diagram the whole biosynthesis pathway of the eicosanoid.